A very good morning, dear students. Welcome back to your social science class. Dear students, today let us continue chapter 5, the Vedic age. Already we were discussing about how the Harappan civilization it came to an end and how the Indian civilization it started. Already in previous class we discussed that the Aryans came to India and they captured the northern part of India and they started to live in India and the Indian civilization it started. And about the Aryans, how the Indian civilization it was, this all about them, the information we are getting from the Vedic literature. And in the previous class we discussed about the Vedas, the Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Adharva Veda. And we have seen how the Aryans people, they were living in that time, the lifestyle of them in the society and all we have discussed in the previous class. And in today's class, mainly we can see the Varna system. When we are discussing about the Varna system, we can say that the society, the Aryan society was divided into the basis of Varna. The Varna means it is the skin color. And we can say the society also, the Aryan society also, it is divided into the basis of the Varnas. And we can see the fair skin, Aryans considered the dark skin Dasas inferior. And the fair skin means those who are the white skin. And they are considered the dark skin, those who are the black and all, those who are dark skin, they are the Dasas and inferior. Inferior means they are the low. And the Dasas were the original inhabitants of the region where the Aryans settled. So the Dasas was the original one, the where the Aryans they settled. So the society it is divided, or the society it was divided on the basis of Varnas. And we can see here the society was divided into the four sections. The four sections are there. We can see here the Brahmins, the society is divided, the Varna system, you can see the society is divided into four sections. The Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. These are the society is dividing four sections. The Brahmins, Kshatriya, Vaishya and the Shudra. And we can see who is the Brahmins. We can say that the Brahmins are the priests who looked after the religious matters and this recited prayers were the Brahmins. The Brahmins were the priests and they are looking after the religious matters, or they are reciting the prayers and they are looking after the religious matters. They are the Brahmins. And the second one, they are the Kshatriyas, you can see. They are the king and they king and the warriors and who protected the tribes from the harm. The Kshatriyas were the king and they are protecting the tribes from the harm and all. And the Vaishyas were mainly farmers and the craftsmen. The Vaishyas were the farmers and the craftsmen. Those who work for others were Shudras, and those who are working for others, they are the Shudras. And Dasas and those Aryans who consider social rules were also considered as Shudras. And we can say that those who are working for other people, they are the Shudras and they are called the Dasas also. And those who are not doing the social rules of the Aryans, those who are disobeying the rules of the Aryans, they also considered as a Dasas or the Shudras. And later Dasa meant slave, and the Dasas they meant slave. Slave means one who is working under the other people. So that is the Varna system. When we are saying about the Varna system, we can see the Varna system, the society is divided into four sections. We can see the Brahmins, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas and the Shudras. And again we can see the system of the social division, it is based on the occupation. Before the social division, it was according to the basic of the occupation. Those who are doing the same job or the occupation and all, they are coming under one group. But later developed into the caste system. After that, later what happened? They are dividing according to the caste system. And the Aryan's family was headed by male. The men was the head of the family. The Aryan's family's head was the male or the men. And the male ancestors were also worshipped and kingship became the hereditary. And they are the kingship and all, they are having according to the hereditary. Hereditary means you know that if the grandfather is doing the kingship, and it is normally it is coming to the father, and again it is become after the after father it is coming to the son. So this is the from grandfather to the father and son it is going. So it is the hereditary, and the kingship also it is the became hereditary. And the women were considered inferior and were not treated well and not allowed to attend the public meetings and all. And the women, they are the inferior. Inferior means they are the low. And the, they are not considering as the or they are not treated well, and they are not going the outside the public meeting and all. And the Aryan's life was divided into four stages. And the, again, the Aryan's lifetime, it is divided into four stages. We can see during the Vedic period, they are dividing into the four stages. You can see the Brahmacharya. The first stage is the Brahmacharya, and second stage it is the Grihastha, and the third stage it is the Vanaprastha, and the fourth stage it is the Sannyasa. So the lifetime of the people, the Aryan's life, is divided into four stages. You can see the Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and the Sannyasa. These are the four stages of the Aryan's life. So next we can discuss about the occupation. When we are discussing about the occupation of the Aryan people, we can say that the main, the important occupations was the agriculture. The Aryans, they were doing the main important occupation, it is the agriculture. And also they grew the wheat, barley and the millet. And they are growing more the wheat, barley and the millet. And the hunting and cattle breeding also remained important occupation. And the hunting and the cattle breeding, this also the important occupation they were doing. The main occupation is the agriculture. And they hunted the wild buffaloes and the bears and other animals for their meat and the skin. And they are hunting the wild buffaloes and all, and the other animals also they are hunting for what? For the meat and the skin. And the bulls were used for ploughing and drawing carts. The bulls, you know, the cow is the female and the bulls it is the male, and the bulls it is using for the ploughing, the to for the in the field and all. They are ploughing the soil and they are drawing the carts. And the cows were reared as they provided the milk, and the cows it is providing the milk for the people. And the wealthy and the rich family was assessed by the number of the cows it owned. And those who are having the, according to the number of the cows, they are saying that they are the wealthy and the rich families and all. And cows were given also as fines for the misdeeds. And they are giving the cows as a fines for the misdeeds. They are doing anything wrong or the misdeeds and all, they are giving for the, as a fine, they are giving the cows. And the Aryans also used the horses which had been brought from the Iran and the Central Asia. And the Aryan people, they were using the horses. They brought the horses from the Iran and the Central Asia, and they were using these horses. And the horses was mainly, they were used as the means of transport. The horses they were using for the means of transport, for the transportation and all, they are using the horses. And we can see that they were used for the riding and drawing chariots. And the chariot racing, it is used to be their favorite pastime, and ownership of the chariot was the status symbol in the society. They were using the horses they brought from the Central Asia and the Iran. They brought the horses, and they were using the horses here for the transportation and all. And the main, they were using the chariot racing. The horses, they were using the chariot racing, and this is the pastime. They are making the pastime and ownership of their chariots and the status symbols of the society. And the we can see in the Rig Veda, they are mentioning about the the artisans were there, the craftsmen and the carpenter, the potter and the chariot maker, the weaver. This all we can see in the Aryan society. And next we can discuss about the food, dress and the amusement of the Aryan people. And we can see the Aryans ate simple food like wheat, barley and the vegetables, fruits and the meat. They were eating the wheat, barley and the vegetables, the fruits and the meat and all. The Aryan people, they were eating But the cow was not killed for food, and they are not killing the cow for the food. And they drank a great deal of the milk and used plenty of ghee. And they are having more many cows there, so they are drinking the plenty of milk and they are getting the plenty of ghee and all. So their thirst, that is the food already we told, they are eating or they are having the food like the wheat, barley and the vegetables, the fruits and the meat and all. And also they are not killing the cows and they are getting the milk from the cows and they are making the plenty of ghee. And when we are discussing about the thirst of the people in the Aryan, we can see their dress consisted of mainly two pieces of the cloth. It is mainly two pieces of the cloth, the upper and the lower covering, and they are covering the upper part and the lower they are covering. And the turbans also, were used, and both men and women, they used the ornaments, they were using the ornaments and all. The ornaments were made up of the beads, gold, silver and the other metals. And this is the dress. Already we told that the dress, they are covering their upper part and the down part, and they are using the men and women, they were using the ornaments. And we can see the amusement of the Aryan people. The Aryans were the chariot racing. They are with the horse and they are making the chariots, and it is the chariot racing they are doing, and the hunting and the gambling, horse racing, dancing and playing musical instruments. And these are the amusement they are doing. Mainly it is the chariot racing, and they are doing the hunting and the gambling and horse racing and dancing and playing the musical instruments and all. This is the mainly the for the amusement they are using or playing. For music they use the flute, veena and the drum, and for the music they are using the veena, drum and all. And this is the amusement they are having. So next we can discuss about the religion of the Aryan people. When we are saying about the religion of the Aryans, we can say that the earlier Vedic period, there it is having the the gods, they are the Indra, Varuna and the Agni. They lost their importance and they replaced the Prajapati or the Brahma there as a creator. And we can see the Vishnu is the preserver and the Shiva the destroyer. And before they are having the Indra, Varuna and the Agni and all, they lost their importance and they replaced the Prajapati or the Brahma. And we can see in this time, this period time, the Hinduism it exists today. What it is existing today, it started in this time. Or the sacrifice amused great importance and religious worship became very complex. So this is the religion we can find in the Aryan society. They were started the Hinduism in this period and all. And next we can discuss about the education of the Aryan people. When we are discussing about the education of the Aryan people, we can say that the girls, they were studying at the home only. The girls received the education in the home itself, at home itself. And the boy, they spend his student's life in the Gurukul. Gurukul means they are going near to the guru or the teacher and they are living there. The boy, he spent his student's life in the Gurukul, and where the guru, or the guru means it is the teacher, lived with his family and the people. And the boy also, he is going near to the guru. The guru is living with the with his family and the people. And the people serve the guru in return for the knowledge gained. And what all the knowledge they are gaining from the guru, the boys, they were giving they are saving the guru as return. And the knowledge was passed on orally in Sanskrit. And the knowledge the guru is giving in the orally, they are not written or anything, they are giving orally, and it is in the Sanskrit. And most of this knowledge was from Vedic literature, and all this knowledge it is getting from the Vedic literature. And they are taught the grammar and the astronomy, the medicines and the art of the warfare, the music and the architecture. This also they were the guru, they teaching to the students. So this is the education they are getting. And next we can discuss about the Chalcolithic culture. When we are saying about the Chalcolithic culture of the Aryan people, we can say that the discovery of the first metal, the copper, it brought the new era for the man's life. When they discovered the copper, the first metal, the life of the people, it changed. It made the new era for the man's life. And the people, they learned to use the copper, tin, bronze and the iron. Then they started to use the copper, tin and the iron. And in the North India, we can see the people, they switched to copper from stones for the mixing of axes, spear heads and other objects. And this period, after the Neolithic age, when the copper was used along with the tiny stones implements, is termed as the Chalcolithic age. And when this period they were using the copper, it is used with the tiny stones and all this time, it is known as the Chalcolithic age. When they were using with the copper and the tiny stones, it is mixed and using, that is called the Chalcolithic age. And in India, we can see there was on no Bronze Age such as, and in India there is no Bronze Age, and the use of the bronze here started in the Copper Age. And so we generally call this intermediate age the copper or the bronze age. And during the bronze here, they started in the copper age. So we are calling the intermediate age. So the copper and the bronze age. And the use of the iron started much later, which marked the beginning of the iron age in India. And when we are started to use the iron, that started the later, and which it is marked the beginning of the iron age in India. So this is the Chalcolithic culture. We can see in Chalcolithic age, when we are discussing, we can say the people, they are using the copper and the stone age, the small stone implements, with that they are using, that is the Chalcolithic age. And we can see what is the features of the Chalcolithic age. The Chalcolithic age culture in India traditionally included the non-urban, the non-Harappan and the culture which made their first appearance around the 2000 BC and were eventually replaced by the iron using culture. The Chalcolithic people, they were built the rectangular and the circular houses of mud in the clusters, and they were not the acquainted with the burnt bricks, and the fire worship seems to have been a very widespread phenomenon among the Chalcolithic people. In the fire altars have been found the number of the Chalcolithic site, and the number of the Chalcolithic age, and the people, they were making their houses, the rectangular and the circular houses, mud, most the clusters, and they were using the fire altars. We can found it is in the number of the Chalcolithic age. And next we can discuss about the megalithic burials, how they are burying the people. It's a memorial for the dead people, and the word megalithic comes from the two Greek words. This words, the megalithic, it is coming from the two Greek words. We can see the mega meaning it is a big, and the lithos it is meaning the stone. So the megalithic means it is the stones, or the it is means that the big or the large stones. The megalithic means it is the big or the large stones. It is making this word, it is arrayed, or it is from the Greek words. Mega means it is the big, and the lithos means it is stone. So the megalithic, it means that the big stones. And many tribes of India, they are having built various megalithic architectures since the Neolithic and the Chalcolithic age. The Neolithic and the Chalcolithic times, we can see many tribes there in India, they are building the various megalithic architecture and all. And the megalithic were the burials in the graveyard away from the area where the people live, and where the people, they are living from there, it is away from the places where they are burying, they are doing the burial. And the megalithic have various shapes and the forms, and the after the burial they are, we can see the megalithic, it is having different types of the forms and the shapes and all. These shapes and forms may may have been used by the different tribes for dead people according to their hierarchy or the importance or to show the different causes of the death. And they are using this, the megalithic, already we told that the megalithic, it is a big stones, and they are after the burialing of the people. After dying the people, we are burialing the people, and after that they are keeping these megalithic or the these stones, they will keep there. And we told that these stones, the big stones, it is having different shapes and the different forms, and according to the people, they are the hierarchy and the importance of the people and the different causes of the death and all, they are keeping these the stones. And the many megalithic burials have been found around the Nagpur in the Maharashtra, and the Muski in the Karnataka, and the Nagarjuna Konda in the Andhra Pradesh, and the Adichanallur in Tamil Nadu and Kerala. These are the places we can see many megalithic we can find. And the megalithic burials show a variety of methods for the disposal of the dead bodies. And the megalithic, it is showing the dead bodies, or the how the varieties of the methods and the disposal, how they are keeping for the dead bodies. And in some cases we can see the bones of the dead were collected in large urns and buried in a pit. And in some cases they are collecting the bones of the dead bodies and they are burying or they are keeping in the pit. And this pit was marked by a circle made of stones, and after that the circle they are marking, after keeping the pit the things, after that they are making the circle, it is made up of a stone. And another kind of the megalithic burial, it is found is a grave with rows of stones in a diagonal or the square pattern. And other burial, the megalithic burial, we can see they are making the rows of the stones in the diagonal or the square pattern type. They are making, these are the megalithic burials we can see. After the death of the people, they are burying the people in a different, the with the burying after, they are keeping the stones. That is called the megalithic burial. So in today's class we have discussed about the Aryan people, the Varna system, how they are divided the society, and the how the life of the people and the occupation and the food and the dress, amusement, the religion, the education, how they are getting. And at last we have seen the Chalcolithic culture and the megalithic burial.